بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمد ونصلي على رسول الكريم أما بعد. Historians have written the most effective way to destroy people is to deny and obliterate their own understanding of their history. If you don't know your history, then you won't know anything. You are a leaf that doesn't know it's part of a tree. And when a person is void of their history, they will make the same mistakes again. That's why the Quran and the Qisas of Anbiya and people of the past play an important role in our lives. And we need to go back in history and see the beginning, where technology and all the asbab that are connected to technology, how it can have an impact on our lives and how it's connected to shaitan. Firstly, وَإِذْ قُلْنَا لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ اسْجُدُوا لِآدَمَ فَسَجَدُوا إِلَّا إِبْلِيسَ. Iblis didn't make sajda, so already the animosity began, the war began. Now the fawqiyat and the virtue of Adam alayhi salam is وَعَلَّمَ آدَمَ الْأَسْمَى كُلَّهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught Adam alayhi salam things which the farishtas could not answer. La ilma lana, that we don't know, Ya Allah, whatever you have taught is in your ilm. So the virtue of Adam alayhi salam was based on his knowledge. Das aqal, das understanding. So this transhumanism is to surpass, where we hear nowadays the common word AI, artificial intelligence, is shaitan wants to surpass insan in his aqal, and when he surpasses insan, that will make insan ghayr aqil. He will lose his senses, he will lose his perception, he will lose this power of knowledge and deferring, recognizing between haqq and batil. He will lose his shuur, he will lose his senses, every capacity and power which insan can have. So looking at the beginning of time, and as time went down, Sulaiman alayhi salam, وَاتَّبَعُوا مَا تَتْلُوا الشَّيَاطِينَ عَلَى مُلْكِ سُلَيْمَانَ وَمَا كَفَرَ سُلَيْمَانَ. So under this ayah, Ibn Kathir has listed the knowledge of that time. One narration is that all the matters of Sulaiman alayhi salam were written and it was buried under the kursi. And the katib was Asif, and he knew all of it, what was written there. So all the lines that were written, all the power, the knowledge, I'm just going to go into a quick summary because there's a lot of details which for now is not necessary. But looking at the time, that one narration, and the other one is where the shaitan came in the form of Sulaiman alayhi salam and he took the ring, and at that time they wrote all the information needed to control, to subjugate the universe. And that was buried under, and that was recovered later on. That's details which you won't get into now. One narration mentions Ahlul Iraq, that Iraq plays an important role in this. وَمَا أُنزِلَ عَلَى الْمَلَكَيْنِ بِبَابِلَ هَارُوتَ وَمَارُوتَ. Harut and Marut were two angels. When the angels objected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that this insan will cause fitna and fasad on the earth, they were told, choose your best farishtas. These two were chosen. They were told that don't commit zina, don't drink alcohol, don't kill. There's different narrations as well in this, a lot of detail. Just one of them was that a beautiful girl came to entice them. She said, on condition you accept my religion, whether it's Judaism, whether it is idol worship, etc. They refuse. She said, okay, you need to kill this child. They refuse. She offered them many things. Amongst the things she offered them was, okay, alcohol. So they said that is very light. When they consumed the alcohol, they became drunk, they killed the child, and they committed zina. After that, they made tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah gave them the option of punishment in this world or year after. They chose dunya. But they came with certain words, the Asma'i Husna, according to some ulama. But that could be converted, how it could do good things, it could do bad things as well. So there is a knowledge from the unseen world which can impact our life in this world. Now, keep that in mind. Babil in the Quran, in today's times, which we say in Babylon, is today's Mesopotamia, which is in Iraq, and that's why we mentioned that about Iraq. Now, the Freemasons, their merkaz is also Babylon, and their origin is from there. So there's unseen knowledge, there's literature, there's certain powers, there's certain things which are out there. Now in the olden days, the alchemist wanted to turn sand into gold. But through these formulas, you could do a lot of things. So they said that the elite in those days mastered the art of alchemy. One great authority of the New World Order says, and this alchemist was launched and initiated in 1666. Now we did previously, the triple sixes is a sign of the beast, which is the Dajjal, and according to them, their savior. So this New World Order person came with certain knowledge on that date, and it was quoted in the books. It was the incredible knowledge that startled and inspired the alchemists of Helvetius's day. It was on that date. And though these learned and determined men never did acquire the philosopher's stone that would transmute lead into gold, they did fashion the seeds of science of chemistry that accomplished so many transmutations of the human environment and the human condition in the last 300 years. The Duke of Brunswick, who is the Grand Master of the World Freemasonry, has warned, so I've been convinced that we as an order have come under the power of some very evil occult order, profoundly versed in science, both occult and otherwise, though not infallible, their methods being black magic. That is to say, now, just a link of jadu, seer, black magic, thus knowledge, to modern technology. And he continues, electromagnetic power, hypnotism, all of these are instruments that want to control people, hypnotize you. Then he says, we are convinced that the order is controlled by some sun order, after the nature of the Illuminati, if not by that order itself. There exists a government with its own air force, its own navy, its own fundraising mechanism, and the ability to pursue its own ideas of national interests, free from all checks and balances, free from law itself. Here they mention Illuminati, Sun. If you look at the Microsoft logo, you'll see, and I'm not going to get into detail again, there's a lot of detail on Microsoft and the Satanism behind it, but just the one logo where the light is coming from. So one is light, which they worship the sun, and the actual sun worship is Iblis, Shaitan, and they're waiting for the real sun to come, which is Dajjal. You see the sun coming out, and that sun is from the east, because in their belief, the east is where the sun rises, and Babylon, which is their merkaz, which is their foundation, that's the place which they originated from. Now coming back to this blending of technology, which will reach its climax, but slowly in the past it started small with just normal television, normal cartoons, then it got more worse, and then it was propaganda, extra truth, the different mediums of media, and now it's going on the next level. But the last level, as explained previously, was where you have virtual worlds where people will go into this world, and you will have augmentation, and you will have interaction, and you will have the joining of human beings with technology. So they say that the fundamental pillars of this transhumanism is the bodies, the thought and the behavior. These are fundamental policies which Shaitan wants to get. And this body now starts getting augmented capabilities. And nowadays, it's far-fetched, but in the future, they want to create contact lenses where you can take videos, pictures, etc. You will have earbuds where you will communicate anywhere in the world, exosuits, RFID chips, where you can unlock doors, etc. But they say in the most powerful augmentation will be biological augmentation, which was discussed previously, where they play around with your genomes in IVF technology and CRISPR gene editing technology, which was discussed previously. The idea was one continuously monitor person, but brain interfaces. And these brain interfaces today, if you look at Elon Musk, Facebook, they've called under Neuralink and DARPA, these are all mediums to combine and to facilitate all of these structures. Then they have things which will increase your dopamine, where they have rewards like above and beyond. Now, the US inventor and entrepreneur, and some of them now are preparing for that. So if you look at the PayPal founder, Peter Thiel, Eric Drexler, nanotechnology pioneer, they have asked and requested, and they've already secured agreements for their bodies to be stored in liquid nitrogen and cryogenically be preserved. And these facilities have already been constructed, whether it's in the US, there's one in Russia as well. And these are places built to house the corpse of humanity. Why? Because they believe that when machines come, we will be resurrected. They believe that the turning point will be 2030, where biotechnology will enable human beings to union and to unite with computers and AI systems. The result will be what? A human-machine mind. And they envisage a day when memory chips and neural pathways are actually embedded into people's brains, thus bypassing the need to use external devices such as computers, etc. And they say, and these are words, if we want to live in paradise, we will have to engineer it ourselves. If we want to live eternally and eternal life, then we will need to rewrite our bug-ridden genetic code and become godlike. Only high-tech solutions can ever eradicate suffering from the world. This is their justification. It's got nothing to do with eradicating suffering. They want to become godlike. They want to become an ilah. And that's this preparation of Dajjal. In Who Owns the Future, it is mentioned of the only significant difference is that the aim of godlike capabilities in humanity, and they've called it humanity 1 and humanity 2. At the heart of this is the removal of the basic rights of humanity 1. And they say that non-augmented human beings will be replaced with duties towards the future augmented humanity 2. Hence the very code of our being can and perhaps be monetized. Personal autonomy should be seen as a politically licensed franchise, where people will become like land, they will trade in land and control people. Socially, masses may thus be forced to serve this techno-scientific super-project of humanity too, which uses the ideology of market fundamentalism. The only significant difference is that the stated aim of godlike capabilities humanity too is overt, and they want to control the world through this year. Now, amongst the people in history, and I'm not going to go very far back, 1914, John Whiteside Jack Parsons, who invented the rocket engine, the rocket propellant, liquid fuel, solid fuel, He got involved in the satanic world, and his ustad was Aleister Crowley, was a so-called imam of Satanism. He founded the religion of Thelema. Now that's a very satanic cult. In 1904, when he went with his wife on a honeymoon to Cairo, they performed some acts, some very, very bad acts in the pyramids. And then he said he seen supernatural entity who was named Iwas, who provided him with the Book of Law, the sacred text that served as a basis of Thelema. That was his whole culture. Do what thou art, well, do whatever you want to. That was their usul and principle. Through the power of magic. So they were trying to blend magic. Now this Aleister, they said Aeon, and he said he was a prophet. He wrote the book, The Magical and Kabbalistic Correspondence. The Kabbalah, we need to study that. He said he wants to bring Oriental wisdom to Europe and to restore paganism in a purer form. Paganism was joining animals with men, now they want to join machines with men. The definition of magic that included almost all forms of technology as magic, adopting an instrumentalist interpretation of magic, science and technology. During rocket tests, Parsons often recited Crowley's poem. So when he was doing his inventions and linked to this laboratory, and I'm just going to quote you his words, Parsons' words. I, Belarion Antichrist, in the year 1949 of the rule, do make manifesto to all men. I, the Antichrist, come among you saying. Means I am part of the Jamaat of Dajjal. And I, Belarion Antichrist, come among you preaching the word of the beast 666. Which is, there is no law beyond do what thou art well. Means follow your nafs and khaish, which technology is giving you. And I do uplift my voice in prophecy, and I say, I shall bring to all men the law of the beast. Through technology, we will bring the law of Dajjal. And his law, I shall conquer the world. I'm quoting his words verbatim. And within his mentioned time, Babylon, very important, we highlighted earlier. And all those who accept me, the Antichrist, the law of the beast, shall be accursed, and their joy shall be a thousandfold greater than the false joys of the false saints. In the name of Belarion shall thy work miracles confound our enemies, none shall stand before thus. Therefore I, the Antichrist, call upon all chosen and elect, and upon all men, come forth now in the name of liberty, that we may end forever the tyranny and the seal on this day. And he's quoted Babylon 4666. Now, in the book of Genesis, Namrud, origin was Babylon. Likewise, Freemasonry, origin. Likewise, Lady Gaga, now 29th of May 2020, a song which she launched, ancient biblical themes were discussed in her launch. And the father of modern science, Francis Bacon, who was a magician and a Satanist, the House of Solomon is a separate and highly esteemed institution for research, going back what we mentioned. So all this is connected, and all these instruments are connected. We need to be very careful. We need to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We need to turn to Allah and make tawbah. May Allah give us tawfiq. The day of Jummah, let us read at least 100 times durood, morning and evening. Jummah, more every day, at least 100 times. Whoever reads durood on Nabi alayhi salam, mukhlisan, with sincerity, 10 times, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you read one durood 10 times, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send 10 durood, 10 stages elevated, and 10 rewards written, and 10 sins forgiven. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq of making amal. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين